miles up in the first tee of the second and final round. After a good drive, the opening hole, Karl finds himself about 80, probably 80 yards out. Again, he doesn't have a rangefinder because he lost his. That's a good shot. Really good shot. So how good's this? First hole of the day. First group off. Bang. Now, Karl's driver's just stopped in his own pitch mark on the fairway here because the fairway's very wet. He's pretty sure he's got some mud on his ball here, so hopefully he can get it airborne. Right, Karl's 120 yards from the flag. Well, that's a mile short. Helps when you've got a rangefinder, I guess. Right, Karl's got about a 30-foot putt here. Yeah, good lag. Very good lag. It's par. That's gone way, way right. Perfect. Karl's got probably 20 feet here. Good putt. Oh, it's a good shot. Right under the hole. Can't buy a putt. Come back down. Yeah, it's all right. It's a fraction long, but yesterday he was short, nearly put it in the water, so he's erred on the side of caution.
Now, on the previous day, I hit my 8-iron and I barely just got out of the water. So I made sure that that wasn't going to happen today, and I used a 7-iron. And I hit it pure and it went over the back of the green.
Yeah, good chip. Good scrambling. Got a tuft of grass just in front of his ball though, which is what's making him think about what to do here.
Here I used the wedge because there was a little clump of grass, the only clump of grass there that was in, had just happened to be in front of my way. So if I putted it, the ball would have bounced over it and who knows where it could have gone. So I just used a 60 degree wedge to flop it over that clump of grass and let it roll out close to the hole.
Good, very good, very good. Oh, we're as far back as you can get here with this tee box. Can't go any further back. Good drive. The fairway slopes right to left, so he's just firing up the right half of the fairway there. Right, so Karl finds himself about 70 odd yards out. Yeah, good shot. Couldn't get too cheeky with that pin placement. He's got a birdie putt coming up. Gotta hit him. Even if that was a line, it didn't get there. That is really good. Oh God, got a birdie. Actually made a 4-foot putt. Woohoo! Karl's just missed the fairway to the right. He's in the first cut, and the first cut here is actually a couple of inches deep. So he's got to guard against the club grabbing and going left here. Oh, nearly hit the flag.
And on this shot, one of the reasons I hit it long was because number one, it took a flyer out of the rough. And number two was because I didn't have the range finder and I was second guessing with my yardages. But all in all, it was a great shot, in my opinion. I thought it was going to be a lot closer, but it just went... It only went about 10 feet past, but just rolled off the back. Now, on this chip shot, I didn't use a putter because I was just a little bit too far off the green, so I used the 60-degree. And you'll see me go up to the fringe to, like, tap my foot down to see if how the ball would react if it landed on the fringe putt. Because if I landed it on the green, I would have been 10 feet by. So I wanted to land it where the ball would have just held up a little, but released on after it landed on the green. And obviously that worked, and I tapped it into the putt.
Nice. Very nice. Good shot. Right, so coming out of the rough, Karl's ball just flew a little bit longer than he would have liked. Let's see how he goes here. Not bad. Good form. That's water.
This hole, I hit my drive. I hit it good. I got caught up and blocked it. And it went into the water. I was pretty mad that I went in the water, but oh well, it happens. And so I measured it and I got it. I got my rangefinder back, by the way. And I got like 102 yards, and there was a little gap under the trees to punch a shot. Now, in the Junior Worlds, in the Callaway Junior Worlds, I hit a shot like this on the 13th hole, and I just thought about this the whole time. So I just went up to the green and they said it was on the green and I was happy. And there were three balls on the green. One was about 30 feet, one was about 20 feet, and one was about 10 feet. I just thought it was the 30 footer, but it was a 10 footer and I was just so happy at that point.
Way down there, next to the lake, to within about 6 feet. See how he goes. Oh, that's a good four. That's a very good par. That's in the mayor's office. It's a dog leg left and he's taking that around the corner. That's in position A. I'll see if I can get it actually. It's about 30 yards past that white stake there. You should be able to see it there. Alright, Karl's 130 out after a really good drive. Yep, 10 feet under the hole. That'll work every time. Birdie. Very nice. Well, Carl's got a par 3 here, fairly long one. I don't know where that's gone. Well, Carl's airmailed the green and he's had to take a drop here. So he's got that for a bogey now. Want Carl to tidy up for his bogey. Well done. Put him down for bogey. Himself about 100 out. Right now, Karl, you want to be putting this slightly left to the pin, buddy. Good shot. Good shot. Good shot, Karl. Good birdie. Alright, we've got a par 3. Carl's up first. Oh yeah, good shot, about 8 feet under the hole, good chance of birdie there as well. Okay. A really good look at birdie here, Carl. You know the line, you know what it's going to be. You didn't hit it, Chief. Pardon me. See the par for a 16th. Carl's currently sitting one over par.
Four.
Good you look at your replay here, Karl, that ball was so far back in your stands, I guarantee that you have duck hooked that left. But Karl's made a challenge for himself here.
This hole was a bundle of fun. I pulled my drive left and then I thinned my 3-wood to about 30 yards short of the green. The day before, on the first round, I had the same shot and I knew it would pull up. So I landed it up further to the hole and it worked and it checked up and I was about 4 feet short with a good uphill putt for par.
Good shot. Nice. Very good. All right, Karl to tidy up for his par. Didn't say it was the most clinical par he's done. It's a very good little bumper run though. Yep. There's no room on the scorecard for how you make your par. All right, after a good bit of scrambling on the last hole, let's hope Karl gets the ball in the right position in his setup before he pulls the trigger. He must have that ball forward in order to avoid the draw. Karl's going to be firing into a really tough pin here because the pin's only a couple of paces on. It's going to be very hard. Oh, it's going to be a very good shot to get this time.
On this shot, I was about 130, 125 yards out. So I just hit a pitching wedge full shot at the flag, hoping it would at least spin back, get close to the hole, giving me an uphill plus birdie.
Oh, that's tight. It's a great shot. Let's get the pace right on this putt. Again, you have barely gotten to that hole. So all the break is happening in those couple of inches before the hole. You've got to hit them, son.
On the second shot here, I wasn't trying to get to the green, not at all. I was about 260, 265 out, so I just hit a 3-wood down a 20-yard gap, which would leave myself with an uphill chip shot.
This is a 501 yard par 5 and Karl's about 5 yards short of the green. And this is a modified blue tee, so on the par 5s they played off the championship tees, which are black, and on the rest of the holes they played off the blue tees.
On this chip shot, it wasn't far, but it was like the shot on 16 where I had to save par, except this time it was for birdie. So I just chipped it up, knowing it would check again because the guy before me hit it and it stopped up. So I just landed it about 5 yards short and it checked up to about 2 feet right and I tapped it in for birdie.
That's a good shot. Okay, Karl to finish with a birdie and square with the card. It's only a foot and a half. His short game's been very good today. a look at your putter path there, mate. Well done. Good birdie.
My motivation to, I was three over through four holes, and I didn't want to shoot the same number as I shot on the first round, so I really tried to fight hard and get back to at least stay at three over or get to even or under par.
Hang in there. Finish square with the card for the day. Well done.
All right, let's starting with the freshman sophomore division. I need 151, Lance and Robbins and Karl Vilips.
Behind you.
Congrats. Lance is still here? Where'd Lance go?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're here at the Carolina Trace Country Club. Got a nice back view of the lake. Wonderful golf course. Robert Trent Jones Sr. designed this course in 1971, and kind of tough. And the kids had a little trouble with it, but overall they have just converted to the new Bermuda greens. And these are the three winners that we have with us here for second and third.
Thank you.